Good afternoon. Right, the other day it had been 100 years since the Battle of Verdun, and I saw that but kind of forgot about this game. So it's a bit late, but this is Verdun, the game, and it's actually pretty badass. I don't play it much, but when I do, I always enjoy it. I really should get into it more. And it needs to be more popular, so given the impeding Battlefield 1 as well, I think more interest should be shown to this game, which does it really well in a more realistic fashion that Battlefield 1 undoubtedly won't be. It's going to be awesome in kind of a visual sense, I'm sure, because EA do that pretty well. And it'll be on Frostbite, so you just know it's going to look and feel good, but it's just not going to be realistic like this. So check this out. Just reload the server browser here. Okay, what we got? The server looks good. I'll join a French squad. So the game's called Verdun, but there are obviously other battles in it as well, else it would be a bit boring, just one part of the front, although Verdun was an absolute fucking meat locker of a battlefield. If you're interested in history generally, and specifically World War I history, the best podcast ever fucking made on the subject is Dan Carlin's. Christ, I've forgotten the name. Dan Carlin's Apocalypse or something. Blueprint for Armageddon, that's it. Check it out, it's free, it's on iTunes. I don't mean to be advertising it, but it is fantastic. So just check it out. He has a whole section on Verdun, and he describes it in horrendous detail. It was a horrible, horrible battle. Here we are on the Somme, which was an equally horrible battle, I suppose, for the British at least. Oh, God. He just. Motherfucker just stepped on me like it was. Unacceptable. Quite a long way to go. Attacking in this is just so hard. Everyone seems to be lining up on the left flank, so try the same. Now, most other videos you watch of this game will have a crosshair. I just personally hate crosshairs in games, even if other people can use them. I just don't want to. Just personal preference. It also looks a lot better without the crosshair, and right the rest of the HUD, which I have. If I hold T, I have it up like that, but generally I like a clear screen so I can see the enemy and shoot them. And be more immersed. It's all about that immersion, yeah. It's very cool. I think he's already killed him. Look at them animations, gotta love them. If Battlefield 1's anything like this, I'll be so happy. But with 64 players and vehicles and planes and all hell breaking loose,
but I fucking guarantee it won't be. Which, you know, I mean, it's not Battlefield's made a new formula. And they stick to it. Let's hope they don't do a Battlefront 2 one day. I haven't killed anyone yet. Just died. At least I got in the trench, right? Shit. Oh no. Look at me reveling on top of a, I think, a live officer. He's just like, oh god. The guy's not even phased. 1,000 yard stare. The only thing I don't like is this minimap, it's a bit shit. I prefer to just have a big map I can open with the M key. Even if it didn't have player markers on it, I'd be happy, but... what are you gonna do? Shit. Guys, there's too many of us here, come on. What is this? It's a meeting or some shit. Oh no. Apologies if the audio isn't very good. In fact, I have a chat pop out. Oh, hello Sam. If you're still watching. How's it going? Sorry, I couldn't see the chat. Let me get it open in game, actually. That'll be better. West. Pop out chat. There we go. So yeah, if you want to pop any questions in the chat now, I'll just look at it every now and then and be able to answer that. So, this game has gas. I mean, do you need any other reason to buy it than that? It has gas and gas masks, for Christ's sake. incoming Germans. Shit! How am I not killing him? So bad! God damn it! Oh, hey, time to sell it. Right, so yeah, to get new guns, you basically have to level up, and then you'll see. You can go to your squad and set up, and you'll see my name there. I'm a militia, so each class has different unlocks. And once you get to a certain level, which it should tell you somewhere. Oh, you can unlock them! I didn't even know this! This is new. I'm pretty sure this is new. Okay, so yeah, you can unlock. You can unlock guns by using up your. What points are they? We'll find out. Here we go. Career points. I have 138 career points, apparently. Because I've never unlocked a gun in this game. So there you have it. You play, and I really haven't played this that much. But you play it for a bit and you get career points. Apparently I've amassed 138, so I can probably unlock most guns in the game by now. I just haven't done yet, and that's got to say something to the game's friendliness. I mean, there's no way, like, it's not a condensed skill gap. You can get really good at this. However, you can play with the initial weapons and just generally be good at FPS games and do fine. I'm pretty much dying over and over, but you get the idea. Oh dear. It's pretty much as brutal as the real Somme was. Cool, yeah, I mean the game isn't like massively popular, but I'm hoping if I get a few streams of it in, get a bit better at it. Might start getting some more players. I never have trouble finding the server, mind you, so it's not like it's dead. I just wish it was 64 players. How awesome would this be with 64? Dead guy in front of you, you know you're gonna die soon, man. Squad 420. Okay. En avant! Oh no! I have got gore enabled, right? Yeah. Okay, sweet. Yeah, I'm playing this at complete ultra, apart from particles, which I put to high, just because that does seem to lag out for some reason. And streaming, it seems to be fine. The recent update must have fixed all performance issues, because I'm not getting any, which I used to really badly. Time to sell. How's my audio, by the way, if you can hear me? Is it too loud, or is the mic and game balance right? Because I'm trying to get it kind of perfect, but I think the games are different, I guess. Probably haven't got much longer to attack this, so just gotta go for it. get him. Is that ahead? Dangerous. Okay, now I can see the chat. What is that little pea shooter you've got? Doesn't look like it could kill a squirrel. Get a real rifle. I guess it's time to unlock some weapons then. 138 cap points. Let's have a look at what weapon, because, man. Got some shitty level and pistol. What's that? A launcher? No. No, no, no. What is it? I don't know. I want to unlock the British kits, to be honest with you. Because they are obviously my favourite units. Doughboys squad vote. Sure, yeah, why not? I don't really know what that's gonna do, but. That's not good. Hi, Fatal. How's it going? Thanks for joining. Shit, there's a bunch of them. Oh no, that's friendly. What's that then? Dead guy. Now we're actually getting to the trench. Gotta clear this shit without dying. Which is easier said than done, believe me. There's a flamer. That's concerning. Oh god! Did you see that? That was fantastic. I think that's a guy dying. Yeah. Oh no! I couldn't see the chat because my bloody viewer list was off a bit there. Sorry about that. Okay, let's try and actually do something this round. To be honest, the Somme's probably one of my least favourite maps. The best ones are the ones set in Verdun. It must be the bit they're most passionate about. It's also one of the most interesting battles. although it really was just a meat grinder, as Dan Carlin explained it. Alright, we're defending. What was that? I don't speak French, so whenever he talks, it just makes me laugh. Gas! Oh shit! Gas! No! Oh no, I died. You've fallen victim to mustard gas. And there we go. That was brutal. It's just black and white mustard gas, what the hell? Or is that just the... No, that's just the dead screen. Black and white. Oh, the respawn timer. Well, I'm not doing terribly, but I'm not doing good either. It's been a while since I played. I guess, yeah, I'm just going to unlock the next upgrade for this because it only costs one career point, right? Fuck it then, let's just do it. And next time we spawn, I'm going to get whatever the fuck that is. I don't even know if I'm going to like it because I have no idea what it is. Do I have a pistol as well? Holy shit, I do. Well, that's... Oh. Pistol's pretty fun in this game. You can imagine in trenches, they're kind of up. Not really, because they do... Well, they're not as good as modern pistols, let's just say that. A German? Jesus, he's French. More German every day. That's what you get for peeking over there, over the top. Steez, you mofo. I've killed 3 people so far, which isn't that good, I'll be honest. If you want to see me doing well, watch my first stream of this video of this game, because apparently I was a lot better then. Let's see. I don't know what the fuck this is, but let's find out because it looks pretty badass. Is it like? Is it a machine? It's got to be a machine. Oh, I didn't even realise I was in the enemy trench. Oh, I'm not even a defence trench. Oh dear. Yeah, this is a bad round. We'll do better. Yeah, Sally, it's a pretty cheap game. Like it's always been quite cheap. I mean, you just know Battlefield 1 is going to be like 90 quid if you want the season pass as well. And it's just you're going to have to get premium because you know Battlefield formula and all. I don't know what. There's clearly going to be enemies around this corner. How did I kill someone? I only killed like 2 guys, but it felt like the whole trench were. Alright, I like that unlock. That was worth 1 combat point. What's the next one cost? Oh, I get a bayonet. How much does that cost? Another career point. I think I could unlock, like, if... Oh, what the fuck? Who killed him? I know they're in the trench, you know, but... These dead bodies, man. Look at them. He's still wriggling in my pain. I can hear him. I don't know how inaccurate that thing is. It's obviously a machine gun that's meant to be deployed, but yeah, it's a little excuse for missing him so many times. Is that regarding Battlefield 1? Time to, yeah. Yep, it is. I mean, I guess this is an indie game, really. But could you imagine this gameplay on the Frostbite engine with like at least 64 players and vehicles and that? My god. That would be the dream game. Also guys, if you're interested in games like this generally, like Red Orchestra 2, Squad, a lot of the kind of realism, war games, all that kind of stuff, I generally stream them every week. And I also have virtual reality HTC Vive headsets, so I've been streaming a lot of that. But yeah, by all means, subscribe if you are interested in all that. And now I'm just murking. German gas mask is a pain in the ass, says Phoenix. I think they all were in World War One. They were pretty uncomfortable. Massive things made of like leather and shit. In the heat of battle. Ah, I'm doing terribly. These guys are well far away, and there is realistic bullet drop in this game now, so. And now I'm just murking. That sounds like the end of the round. There's only 32 seconds left. I do have a YouTube channel. And I do upload them now. I only recently started doing that. Really. It's XXL Peanuts, spelled correctly, unlike this channel, which I am going to change soon. I'll let you know if and when I do that. And the battle's a draw, like almost all World War One battles. I kind of love it when it ends like that, because that is really how most battles ended. La guerre n'est pas finie. On reviendra. Roger that, Steve.